Good afternoon, everybody. I am Rekha Sharma. I head nutrition in VLCC. As we all know that the India is going to be the diabetic capital of the world, and we are heading towards diabetes in a very, very rapid way. And there are lots of questions people have. Everybody wants to know what is the right diabetic diet, what one should eat, what should be the normal exercise. So we are going to discuss about the diabetic diet today. Now, just to get the fear out of people, there is no such thing as a diabetic diet. Diabetic diet is a healthy eating practice which involves good quality food, which is good for normal population, and it is also good for diabetics. So diabetics need not fear that it is going to be an imposed diet on them. We generally give the diets out of their family meal which are healthier. So once somebody is diagnosed a diabetic, what is that we are looking for first? First thing is, what is the aim of a diabetic diet? For example, if you are non-insulin dependent diabetic and you are likely to be overweight, so our aim is that one should come to an ideal body weight. If you are overweight, you need to reduce, and some of the diabetics who are insulin dependent diabetics are underweight, they need to gain weight. So first aim is to achieve an ideal body weight. Second is to have your glycemic control. That means the diet should be such that the blood sugars are managed. And third principle is that we should prevent the complications and the degenerative diseases like coronary artery disease or hypertension or other complications that diabetics are likely to have, prevent them away for a few years to come. And then of course it should be an optimal diet, a balanced diet, and if you are a growing child, a diabetic child must grow. So an ideal diet is the one that has all the good balanced components for a diabetic. Now, the quality of diet is very important for a diabetic and for everybody else in the normal population. For example, if we have macronutrients in our diet, that is, we have energy-giving foods, and that will be carbohydrates and fats. And then we have bodybuilding foods, and those are the proteins. And then we have protective foods that prevent us from different diseases like vitamins and minerals and antioxidants. So a diabetic has to have a good balance of these three components. And one thing that the diabetics really need to watch out is, other than the healthy eating practices, adhere to a timing, a meal schedule. For example, if you're on oral hypoglycemic drug, or if you're on insulin, or if you're on none, you're on diet alone, even then it's good to take a small breakfast, a mid-morning, a lunch, an evening tea, dinner, and bedtime. That is to divide your meals equally so that you do not have any peak rise or fall in the blood sugar. And therefore, quality of the diet is very important. When we're talking of quality, carbohydrates make the maximum amount of energy-giving foods in our diet. And studies have shown that if you keep your carbohydrates low glycemic index, that is, if the carbohydrates have enough fiber in them, they will hold on to the blood sugars and the rise will not be rampant. So therefore, all carbohydrates taken should be whole grains like whole wheat bread, whole wheat atta. The pulses and dal that you take should also be with the husk. Lots of green vegetables will give you fiber. Some fruits will also give you fiber. So basically, a low glycemic index fiber, it is good for a diabetic and even for normal population. So they have to share a family meal. Our aim is that we give them a family meal out of the eating pattern that they have. If they are a chapati eating population, we need to give them chapatis. If they are rice eating population, we should give them a rice. There is no taboo against a particular food. Whatever food you take should be accompanied with a fiber. Then we come to proteins. It's very important. So when we are planning a diet, first thing that we need to do is to have adequate proteins for the diabetics, because they are for bodybuilding, they look after wear and tear, and even for elderly, they are good for when the body is getting catabolic. For children, they are good for growth. So what quality of protein? There should be lean protein. In other words, protein that does not have too much fat with it. If you are a non-vegetarian, you can take an egg, you can take low-fat milk, you can take low-fat curds, you can take low-fat paneer or low-fat cheese. Pulses are very good. And if you are vegetarian, you can also take a lot of soya beans in your diet. If you are non-vegetarian, you can take some lean fish, which is very good. It is rich in omega-3 fatty acids. You can take some lean chicken, which is good for you. And then come the protective foods like vegetables and fruits. WHO recommends 4 to 5 servings of vegetables and fruits in a day. So it's good to have whole vegetables of all colors so that you can get all the vitamins and minerals and a good variety. Leafy vegetables are good, they are practically negligible in calories. And then you have other green vegetables which are good for you. When you come to root vegetables like potato or other shakarkandi etc., they should be treated as cereal and not as a vegetable, because they are higher in starch. And all the vegetables that have high fiber are good for you. Fruits is a very commonly asked question. How much fruit can we have? When we are talking of fruit, so one serving of fruit, we take it as about 10 grams of carbohydrate. And when we are talking of 10 grams of carbohydrate, one medium serving apple is, for example, one fruit. If you take an apple, you can take one. If you take a pear, you can take one. Say, if you want to take a mango, then since it has more sugar, the 50% of that is like a mango. So 50 grams of mango. If apple is 100 grams, mango can be taken as 50 grams. Therefore, depending upon the sweetness of the fruit, one can increase or reduce the fruit. One or two servings of fruit is good to have it in a day. When you take a fruit, it's always good to take 2-3 nuts with it, for the peanuts or an almonds, because it controls the blood sugar and the one does not get too much of peak or rise in the blood sugar. So therefore, whenever you're giving fruit, it's good to take fruit away from the meal and to take 2-3 nuts with it to control the sugar that you'll get from the fruit. Then comes the thing, how much can we eat? What is the total quantity required for a particular person? Everybody does not eat the same amount of food. It depends on the age. Older you are, more sluggish your basal metabolic rate. So therefore, you need lesser calories. If you're young and you're growing, you need more calories. So age is a factor. Your sex is a factor. In other words, the gender, that is, the men need more calories than women. And then your height, taller you are, more calories you can afford. But most important is how physically active you are. If you are more physically active during the day, then you can afford to have more calories. So therefore, depending upon the body weight that we need to achieve, since our target is that we achieve an ideal body weight, a diet is planned. And similarly, we have fats in our diet, and the quality of fat is very important. There are 2-3 types of fats that are there in our diet. One is visible fat, that is we are using as a cooking medium. And one is invisible fat that is already present in the particular food, like milk will have some fat, your nuts will have some fat, every item will have some fat or other than the fruits and vegetables. Coming to cooking medium is very important. For a layman, all the saturated fats, that is the fats that are solid at room temperature, like coconut oil or your palm oil, should be totally avoided. It's good to take oils in the diet. And it's good to take monounsaturated fatty acids, in other words, the oils that are rich in MUFA. So coming to the layman's terminology, all oils that are rich in MUFA, the number one is, of course, your olive oil is very good for you. If you do not like to spend that much money on an oil, your rice bran is very good, your gingerly oil is very good, mustard oil is very good, soya bean oil is very good. And it's always good to blend the oil, like for example, if you're taking soya bean, you can have mustard oil along with it, or you can have safflower oil along with it. So the blended oils or to alternate oils is a good idea. But the oils have to be used in moderation. Like 1 gram of oil gives you 9 calories, 1 gram of sugar still gives you 4. So a diet that is planned for a diabetic or any healthy eating practice, like I said, so you have to have, the first priority is take whole grains from cereal group. Then you take low-fat milk and milk products from the milk group. Then you take whole pulses from the pulse group. Then you take fruits and vegetables, 4 to 5 servings, and good quality oil. The sugar is an optional group. In other words, sugar is optional for you, me, for anybody who wants to watch their weight. So the diabetic should avoid sugar in the diet because they are hollow calories. The sugar that we eat, the table sugar that we eat, is there, which has about 1 gram will give you about 4 calories, but they are hollow, they have no vitamins, it has no minerals. So therefore it is good to avoid sugar for everybody who wants to watch their weight. Oil is the second thing in calories, so therefore oil has to be used in moderation as well. So a good balanced diet eaten at frequent intervals is a good thing for a diabetic to have. We have a lot of myth attached in our day-to-day consultation when we see our patients. First of all, the first biggest myth is that now the diet is going to be very exclusive and they will not be able to enjoy life, they will not be able to eat the normal food that the family is eating. I want you to be watching on that there is nothing like that. The diet will be planned from within your family meal so that there is adherence. Now, a lot of studies have shown that if you take a diet which is away from your family meal, which is imposed on a particular diabetic, there is no compliance, and once there is no compliance, there will be no diabetic control. So now the diet has become very liberal. We give exchange lists where you can give a lot of variety. You can choose your own exchanges, you can choose your own cereal, you can choose your own fruit, you can choose your own vegetables, etc., and make a nice palatable diet for yourself. Snacks is another issue for a diabetic. It's always nice to get wholesome snacks that are not fried. For example, you can take some roasted grams with you. When you are traveling, you can always keep some nuts in your car, or you can keep some fruit in your car. If you are an insulin dependent diabetic, it's always good to have an ID card with you, so that people know that you are a diabetic, and it's always nice to carry some quick snack like a packet of biscuits or a chocolate or a toffee along with you when you're traveling, because if you already take an insulin shot and you do have a delayed meal due to some car breakdown or due to some delay in some other way, so it's nice to have a small snack so that diabetic does not go into hypoglycemia. So this is basically a general diet, and I would also like to discuss some queries which we have received. We received one query from Calcutta, from Sushma, and she wants to know that her husband is a diabetic and can he be eating rice since they are a rice eating population. I just would like to inform Sushma that yes, both chapati and rice, and about 20-25 grams, have the same amount of calories. Like one chapati, a small bowl of rice will be same amount of calories, but rice is more refined. In other words, rice has less fiber. So your husband can definitely have rice, but when you give him rice, give a lot of whole dals and vegetables and whole grains with it to reduce the absorption of sugar very fast. In other words, to introduce more fiber into it. Therefore, rice is more than welcome. He can have rice, but with lots of vegetables, whole grains, and your whole dal with it, so that the absorption is reduced. I also have one more query from Chennai by Lakshmi, and she wants to know whether banana can be eaten as a fruit. Like I mentioned earlier, when you take one medium sized fruit as an apple, which is about 100 grams, when you're taking banana, since it is sweeter, about half a banana is equivalent to that much of apple. So they can have banana, but in smaller quantity. There is no ban on any fruit. All fruits have very high rise in blood sugar if not taken with nuts, so that therefore the quantity has to be controlled. Another query we have is from Jabalpur region. The person wants to know that how much can he really walk. Now exercise depends upon your body weight. WHO recommendation for exercise is 150 minutes, minimum 150 minutes of aerobic a week. So it's absolutely mandatory for all the diabetics to walk, unless the sugars are very high and you are getting ketosis and your physician is stopping you from exercising for that particular, those particular days. A normal diabetic who is overweight and leading a normal life must exercise on a regular basis, because the insulin that you are taking or the oral drugs that you are having, it's all based on your total activity and your intake. Once your activity and intake is fixed, only then the doctors decide upon your medication. Therefore, it's important that we have fixed amount of activity and fixed amount of diet practically, so that the oral drugs and the insulin can be managed. Then there's one more call from Patna, from Kamlesh, and she wants to know that now that she is on oral drugs, can she take sugar? Now, once you take sugar in the diet, as I said earlier, they are hollow calories, and the sugar gives rise to 100% blood glucose response. In other words, the blood sugar will rise immediately, and it's not a good idea to have hollow calories in the diet and have immediate rise in the blood sugar. It is always good to have fresh fruit or some other sweetener in your diet, which is not in the form of a pure sugar. Fructose is still considered better, that is present in the fruits. So therefore, a medium size of fruit would be a good substitute for having a sweet tooth. Then I have one more from Kanpur. The Fatima wants to know that can she fast since she has rosas. Now, Fatima, it's a very religious belief, so people do fast, but it is good to take the diet when you start your diet in the evening. It is good to take a total balanced diet after, say, for a few hours. For example, if you're breaking your fast about 7 o'clock, then take something about 10 o'clock. In other words, you can just switch your morning to evening routine. protein. However, you have to take a doctor's advice, because if you're on insulin, whether he wants you to have the 10 to 12 hours of gap. It's not a very good idea for the people to fast, especially if they are on oral drugs or on hypoglycemic oral drugs or on insulin. However, for people who are overweight and are on diet alone, the fasting does not really much create much confusion in their lifestyle or in their blood sugars. But people who are on insulin or on oral drugs, they need to watch out what the blood sugar levels are and consult their physician. So basically, just want to round up by saying that diabetic diet is a good healthy diet, which is there with whole grains, which is there with lot of fiber, which is there with the lean fish, lean chicken or lean meats, and one can take lot of whole pulses, and one can take lots of green vegetables, and fruits to be taken in moderation. But it is important to divide your diet between breakfast, mid-morning, lunch, evening tea and dinner. And when you are eating out, one should watch out for what you are eating out. It's good to leave the gravy part in your eating out. It is good to have, instead of having parathas and puris, it's good to select some tandoori roti or something like that. And it's good to avoid too many fried foods. And it's good to select a small fruit in place of a sweet dish when you are eating out. So basically, it's a lifestyle management where it is healthy eating along with exercise, and one can lead a very normal life and not really have a stigma that I am a diabetic, so therefore I need something very special diet. It's normal healthy practicing, and the diet has to be from within your family meal. Thank you.